door. Watch the door.
More than likely, fire's gone through here and it's gonna run the attic. So the truck crew's gonna cut a hole right now, punch the ceiling, and draw any fire up and out of there.
So they've called knockdown on the fire. They basically have put it out. Now they're just hitting all the hot spots, doing salvage of what might be salvageable in there, like the resident's property. And now it's just overhaul where they literally have to pull everything apart and hit everything that's still smoking and hot and on fire.
From A&E Networks comes Live Rescue, a live reality show that follows our first responders from around the country as it happens. And joining me right now is the host of Live Rescue, Matt Eisman. Hey, Matt.
Hi, Jeff.
All right, so Matt, help me out here. How does someone go from being a doctor in medical school to a stand-up comedian to hosting a live TV reality show? Tell me about that incredible journey.
It was a pretty typical career path. I think there was a moment. I remember it was in January of 99, I was in the intensive care unit in Colorado. It was probably 3 or 4 in the morning. We're getting slammed with patients. And I just had this epiphany of, I'm going to be making life or death decisions. And I just didn't feel like my heart was in it enough to feel good about making those life or death decisions. Decided I was going to take a year off, try stand-up comedy. I told my dad, and I will never forget his response, because it wasn't what I expected. He said, life is short, do what makes you happy. And since then, I haven't looked back. I ended up in entertainment. But now with Live Rescue, I kind of get to bring it full circle and get to employ some of my medical training a little bit anyway. Not in the field, fortunately, but at least in my commentary.
So you're telling me you were a real life Patch Adams?
Yeah, I was. And then I left. So, doing stand-up now, talking about ninjas, and now hosting Live Rescue. It's just how I drew it up.
So, Matt, tell me about getting the hosting gig for Live Rescue. I would assume it takes a special someone that can react live to things as they happen with first responders.
Yeah, they brought me in just to see if I could handle, because logistically, it is unlike any other show in that, A, it's happening live. We're in a studio. We have two panelists who are with us, Styx and Battalion Chief Helani Libdell. And there are 7 cities with 30 cameras. So you might be going to something and all of a sudden something else comes up to be able to throw between it, to be able to talk to people, to be able to process all the information. They wanted to make sure I could handle that. I think the medical training came in handy there. And then a few years of hosting shows like Ninja or Evil Live. So it kind of felt like all my life really had led to this show. And I felt like it's really kind of a show I was purpose built for. And I'm really glad I got the opportunity, because I love what we get to do following these first responders, and not just showing what happens on these calls that they go on, but really showing their lives, giving a little fuller spectrum of what it's like to be a first responder.
Well, Matt, I have tremendous respect for first responders, especially on the second anniversary of October 1 of our massacre that we had here. Our first responders went above and beyond.
So you see how first responders, when they go to a call, they really don't know what they're going to face. And we saw this last week. We were in San Bernardino, and there was a fireman battalion chief who was driving back from a call, happens to see a car accident on the side of the road. And he pulls over thinking it's a fender bender in the middle of the day. It turns out that car was involved in a shooting with another car, multiple shooters in both cars. He drives up. The suspects start fleeing. He just pulled up on a gang warfare and goes from a fender bender to, hey, there could be guns or bullets flying here. He has to respond accordingly, get the police in there, make sure everything is as safe as can be. And you see how in an instant a situation can change, how things are so fluid, and they have to react, they have to respond, and they have to try to save people's lives. It's incredible where people would try to get as far away from that situation. Instead, they head towards it. And that takes a special breed.
Now, considering the subject matter for Live Rescue, when you could see something from an overdose to a car crash to some really horrific things, do you take this home with you, or is there an ability to turn it off when you go home at night?
You know, I think that's what we're learning is to watch it. And it is. Sometimes it's very hard. I think what's different with Live Rescue is that we, I think the show is trying to focus on the hope. It's focusing on the people who respond to these difficult situations, these horrible situations, these life or death situations. And they're the ones who, when people are having the worst day of their lives, they're the ones who go in there to bring hope and who try to turn that day around. And that's what I love about Live Rescue, is we're seeing these firefighters, paramedics, and EMTs. We're seeing them from the moment they get the call as they're driving up. And then as they're interacting in this situation, then we see them in the aftermath too, as they process it. And I think there is something about that that gives us all that relief. It is a very high stakes show. We don't know what's going to happen. So we're discovering it with everyone at the same time. So it is, you know, I can't imagine a more compelling show with higher stakes than Live Rescue.
So Matt, I'm so sorry to hear. No luck at the Emmys this year.
You know what? I would love to. I won an Emmy before back in 2010 for Clean House, a home makeover show. So I've got the trophy. It's nice to be nominated for American Ninja Warrior for our fourth time. But as long as people keep tuning in and we keep getting more seasons, I think I can live.
Well, Matt, you know, I've been doing this almost 25 years. I've done hundreds and hundreds of television shows. I have two Emmys, two nominations, and two wins. And it's true. When you get nominated, it's truly an honor because it's really rare. In fact, there's mine sitting right back there.
And you want to win. And it's nice. You know, I got one. It's kind of like a Super Bowl. You get one, you feel like your career is made, but you start getting greedy. You want a few more. But honestly, I love getting to do what I do. And there's something about people tuning in, and Live Rescue has an unbelievable social media following. People go to AETV on Twitter at AETV, and you can see just how invested people are in the show. Well, I would love to get more trophies. I will take a passionate fan base every day.
Now, if we can't get enough of you, Matt, on Live Rescue, I understand we can book you on a speaking tour.
Well, it depends. You know, I've done a lot of talks. It's nice having been a doctor. I have rheumatoid arthritis. I had a brush with cancer. I host American Ninja Warrior, and now I'm hosting Live Rescue. There are a lot of things. I love talking to people. I love telling stories, trying to bring some humor to it. It's what we're doing on Live Rescue. It's what we do on Ninja Warrior, and it's what I do when I speak. So if you want, go to MattEisman.com. It's just turned into a commercial, Jeff. Hire me to be your next public speaker.
Matt, congratulations on Live Rescue. And when you're done, you need to decompress, come out to Las Vegas. You know, we'd love to have you.
Well, you know, we're there for the finale of Vegas every year. I spend about 10 days there. It's great. We finally went and saw Love, the Beatles show. It was incredible.
That is awesome. So proud that you guys are coming to Vegas. Thanks again, Matt, and good luck.
Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate it.
You can catch Live Rescue on the A&E networks. And for more reviews and interviews, just surf on over to my website at vegasfilmcritic.com. I'm Jeffrey K. Howard in Las Vegas. Thank you for joining me. See you next time.